if I talk a little funny, I am from a place called Dublin, Ireland. Has anyone here ever heard of Ireland? It is a sport, however, that pushes people to the boundaries of what might be possible. By the way, has anybody here ever driven at 200 miles an hour? Intentionally? Because my dad sold vegetables on a corner grocer store and I got to race in the Formula One World Championship. If you dare blink, you miss 50 feet of the racetrack right there. Yeah. This accident changed my life. I had a double compound fracture of the left leg. I had a broken hip joint, broken pelvis, broken ribs, broken hand, broken arm, third degree burns, lacerated liver. Could I consider the accident that almost killed me to be an obstacle that I could overcome? It was an unusual mental ability to put into a compartment that which was really difficult and to use difficulty as your gift. I had absolutely no idea what I just agreed to. But teams go to the victory podium and almost make a statement. My team of people were the best. Did they plan better? Did they execute better? What was it? So if we know what happened in the last decade and we suspect it might continue to get faster in the next decade, does that mean that we need to value speed as a core competency in everything that we do? Speed in my business is not just about going faster. It's actually about being faster. But an even more important element of being faster in my business is the ability to remove the speed bumps that might slow you down. And do you know in the NFL on any given Sunday, 50% of all the teams win? You got the engine, the gearbox, the tires, the tire pressures, the tire temperatures, the aerodynamics, the front wing, the rear wing, the caster, the camera, the track, the rake. There's so many things you can change in a racing car. Because I want to give you a bit of a feel for the culture of how these teams operate. The very culture, how they think, their DNA of an Indy 500 team culture. They live convinced they'll be beaten tomorrow because it is directly proportional to the preparation the teams of people put in before they go against the competition. Just ask yourself that on a Monday morning or a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. As regards my preparation, where am I on the starting grid today for the race I'm in every day? It was a wonderful relief. The only problem was my engine blew up 2 laps later. We're leading the race, so the television cameras arrived. Fired the engine up, released the clutch. The thing was in reverse. Because the greatest power we all possess is the power to choose. The delight for me would be to think that the sport I love so much could potentially help corporate America. But you individually have to make the choice to grab some of the nuggets that you might have heard to get better yourself. Because as you go forward, I promise you, a better you makes a better us. And if you do make that crossover and you do embrace some of the principles I just shared with you here, believe it or not, it doesn't matter what the competition does, because you will be equipped at a much higher level for everything that's going to come your way in the next 10 years. Thank you all so much. Thank you. Thank you.